I used to shave my legs and my arms because in soccer, I was, I don't want to say an asshole, but I was crafty. And people used to pull the hair on my legs because I would do it to other people. Mm-hmm. Right. So yeah. I don't think people really thought about doing it to me until I did it
for
to them.
For a reaction.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Exactly. A very equal. So if we're just, you know, if a guy is supposed to just shadow me the entire game and I do a lot of standing, he's going to be right next to me. So might as well just give that guy a little pull on his hair outside of his knee, you know, just piss him off. Like, hey, fuck you. Like, oh, me. Why are you standing less than an inch away from me for this entire game? But give me a little breathing room. I'm not doing anything. I'm taking a knee right now in the middle of the game, just trying to get a win. Oh, I'm supposed to shadow you all game. It's going to be a long day for you then, bub. Pull his hair again. And he pulls my hair. And then what did I do? Shave my legs so he couldn't pull my hair anymore. Now I'm the asshole with no retaliability at all. It's beautiful.
You're a superhero.
You should have seen the French people, man. They hated it. I had this French guy.
They're
hairy. He ended up kicking me in the chest. Oh. I have a picture of six studs right in my chest because this guy kicked me right in the fucking chest. And I lost my... It was that moment, the whole thing. Yeah, it was a big deal. It was in France. He got a yellow. But I was fucking with that guy the entire game. I mean, it was the entire game I was fucking. I think I even gave him a ball tap at one point. I mean, I was an asshole out there. But so I was a pretty talented soccer player. So people would literally just shadow me the entire game. So it was like, no matter where I went, there's just a guy following me, right? Huge compliment. Huge, huge compliment. But for me, I was sick of it, you know? I like some easy fucking operations here.
Trying to play.
Make me work a lot harder here. So when we went to France, played against a French guy, and I don't know how they knew, but they had a guy just shadowing me the entire game. He acted as if he didn't speak any English. So this is already off to a rough start. So then there was this one time where somebody played me a ball like to my left and he was standing on my right. And I just did like a fake little like whoop poof, like, you know, like I'm gonna go right in the balls. And he was not happy. Not happy. Ref called it too. Ref caught it. So now I'm immediately bad guy number one in the entire country, probably at that point. So a couple of my teammates are like, dude, you did that on purpose? I was like, yeah. And they're like, rough start. It's like first 5 minutes in the game. I get loose probably right before half. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, this fucking guy comes flying in with his goddamn cleat, and it gets me right in the chest, and I just get like...
Oh, it was like a flying kick?
Yeah, yeah. I get there might have been like a volley, or the ball was bouncing, and he just acted as if it was this, but that was definitely a square kick right to my fucking chest, and down I go. He came out with this magnifique spray, this fucking... It was the frozen ice spray that they do. They started spraying my body. I was like... It was a bad situation.
That's the worst retaliation of all time?
Yeah. Yeah. I got people that punched me and stuff, like in the ribs. But I was meant
during the run, right?
Yeah, but I was meant for it. I mean, I was like fucking 45 pounds heavier than I was. It's like, I ain't got time for this.
I'd love to see that guy right now. He's got his own podcast right outside of Lyon, France. I remember that I took my cleat and planted it in his chest.
There's a guy from Turkey I almost got into a fight with. He was on the Turkish national team just this recently. And I didn't know that until I got a message from somebody I played with on the team that I played over there. And it was like, you remember blah, blah, blah. That was the guy you were calling like Rico Swat. He had this hair slick back thing that I was just fucking with him the entire game. And he made it into the fucking Turkish national team. Yeah, it was good. It was all good. My soccer stories, I never really talk about them. I was a fucking character in that sport now. Because I was bigger, stronger, and faster than everybody. So it was as if I was the complete opposite end of the totem pole that I was in the football world. That's why when I got in the football world, I just stopped talking. It's hard to talk shit whenever you're punting balls. But whenever you can kick faster than somebody, run faster than somebody, and score better than somebody.
And knock the piss out of them.
It's hard not to talk shit. And I'll tell you what, I miss those days.
So you're literally Ibrahimovic, like out there, right?
Yeah.
Just faster?
I was fast. I was fast. That's why whenever people talk about that 40 thing, I was like, I think you guys are kind of discounting what one of my major upsides was, which was my speed. But anytime I would go to kick a ball, man, no matter what country they're from, there was an entire fucking flinch city. Like, please don't fucking do this. It was awesome. It was a lot of fun. Free kicks were always like a big moment. Anytime there was a free kick, Like when Beckham was getting hot with free kicks, and anytime there was a set ball play, like when Beckham was in there, everybody would peek their head in, or when Ronaldo was hitting them well there for a while. It was like that for me, but like in little kid soccer tournaments, like, oh, they got one. And like everybody from other field would be like, let's see what this fucking kid does. And then it would either go 45 yards over the net or smoked into the fucking net.
Story your dad tells of you destroying that kid's arm, ripping it out of socket.
Broke his arm. Yeah. Broke the kid's arm. Yeah.
At the elbow.
It was fucking awesome. Ran up and finished the goal too. So the kid gets his arm. So I rip a shot. Kid puts his arm in front of it. Dislocated elbow, I think. Down. Everybody's like, kid falls down crying, and the ball's laying there. Like, go in and tap it in. My mom's like, you're such a fucking asshole. I was like, they didn't blow the whistle. And I think it's now 4-0. I should probably call this one.
Hey, good goal.
Yeah, good goal. Thank you. Yeah. I was a futsal national champion. Which futsal, for those of you that don't know what it is, it's a smaller ball, and it's on like a gymnasium floor.
It's weighted too, right?
Yeah, it's a weighted ball. And if you had a strong leg, that ball would get moving. Oof. And I used to fuck some shit up with that ball now.
Less running there too.
Less running. Ooh. I had good vision too, so it was perfect. Yep. I used to just park it in the back of a diamond. It was 4-on-4. I used to just park it in the back of the diamond. And anytime that ball was just rolling, just a little bit of space, there was a fucking rocket coming at that. We had an American Muscle line, and then there was like these foreign kids on our futsal team, and we had an American Muscle line and then the other line. And it was hysterical. Like, it was me, Tremendous, a couple other people that just had huge legs. We're playing in this national championship in Boston. And then our second line was like a Latino group of kids from Pittsburgh. They were on our team as well. We didn't even speak to each other. We're two different. It was like a line change type thing. And it was fucking beautiful. We would just go out there. And this team had just got done like facing against these little like quick guys. And then all of a sudden we get on the fucking field.
Brutes.
Yeah, we just come in and they're like, oh no. Fucking hammering the ball like 120 miles an hour. See you later.
You ever out and about in the city and you see a guy wearing some shorts and just have that urge? Does it ever come back?
There's a fucking field.
No, not to play. To pull his hair on his leg. No.
That was strictly just to piss the guy off. That was literally just like, I was like, leave me the fuck alone, man. I used to get into it with refs, too. Refs knew me ever since I was a kid because I was always pretty good at soccer. But, I did have some things about me that were a little cheeky, as they call it in soccer. Oh, cheeky, a little cheeky play. So there's always this one ref. He was an older guy, white hair. He was friends with my dad, actually. He was always very hard on me, like very, very, very hard on me. And this one time during a futsal tournament, he kicked me off the field for something. And I told him, like, it was like an S my D, I'll murder your family type thing. And, like, the entire fucking tournament just stopped. And I think I fucked up here. And I just kind of walked into, like, through the penalty box that they had on the basher boards and then, like, right out of the building. My dad was like, you got to be nicer to refs. Like, that's on me. I was a completely different animal in soccer field. I would have hated me. Shaved my whole body, tanned. I was fucking good, though.
For the national ones, did you have to like deal with refs that didn't speak English?
I played in a game in Germany where the guy spoke no English. And that was a wild moment.
I can only imagine.
Because I am a chatty guy, right? So mm-hmm. I got some things to say. Like, hey, this guy is fucking cleating my ankle here. Excuse me, nothing. Nine. Hey, this fucking guy, nothing said. But I just... Soccer used to, if I wasn't so lazy, I probably would have been a superstar. Boy, I think I had asthma though. I think it was undocumented. Right? Yeah. I think I had fucking asthma though. I got tired.
Pretty much, if you were like really good at soccer, you have an aptitude to be great at almost every sport, right?
Well, there's
involves a little bit of everything.
Pat Anger told me that he wishes his kid play. He wants his kids to play soccer because it makes you light on your feet. It teaches you a lot of things. You have to be light on your feet. You have to have good dexterity and you have to have good vision in soccer too, because that's a big field. So you got to see a lot of things happening. I think soccer is a great sport to get your kid in. A lot of conditioning too. I mean, that shit's running forever. I used to fear going to practices because I knew the conditioning test that was coming at the end of it every fucking Tuesday and Thursday. I used to just fear it. Just driving to practice, I'm like, I fucking know what's coming. I'm gonna be good during the practice, but as soon as that thing ends, I know what's coming. We got like 25 minutes of conditioning, and I got no shot. And that started when I was like 11 years old, too, all the way through U18. Like every single practice was basically like a let's hope Pat doesn't die. And then when I played at West Virginia, it was the same fucking thing. I played at West Virginia during the spring, and we would play games. Coach LeBlanc, good guy. We would play. He just asked me if I, he asked each year if I could play. Rich Rod wouldn't let me play. So I played during the spring whenever Coach Stewart, they welcomed me with open arms. It was awesome, but I hadn't played soccer in 3 years. And I was living pretty hard in college. I think we've all heard stories. Got $40,000 in loans out just to party. So, I mean, I didn't live as clean as I should have. But I went and played, and in practice, he created a rule to kill me. We would play a game to five. I would score like four goals. We would win, and it'd be lose or runs. And then okay, you said it. Here we go. I'm going to win this game then. And then it would be like win or lose, McAfee still runs. And I'm like, this is a fucking terrible game. I'm probably not going to show up in these games, by the way. If it's just win or lose, McAfee still runs. He was like, you have to get in shape. I was like, I know. And then I got hit one time, and Bill Stewart was like, Patrick, you know that less than a year from now, this is fun. Soccer's fun. I understand that. But people are going to pay you a lot of money just to kick the ball and not run it off. I said, thank you, Coach Stu. I was actually looking for a reason to get out of here. There's a win or lose McAfee still runs rule that I am about fucking done with. I do see a soccer game that happens over here, though. It's off the exit 65. It's a little pickup game. Mm-hmm. Every time I ride by it and there's people playing, I think about stopping and just ripping their nets. Just whoop. Take the net. No English is being spoken in those games too. Sure, yeah. I give a little look, see, I'm like, I don't know if I can just show up and pop off. I do miss the soccer days though. The knees are probably fucked because of it, but I do miss those days. Used to be a real athlete.
That's part of it.
Now I'm getting old. I don't think I'll let my kid play soccer. He'll play early, but I don't think he's going to be committed to soccer. Not enough money in America.
No.
If you want to be rich in soccer, you got to go overseas.
It's a lot of traveling too, isn't it?
Yeah,
every weekend.
My dad. That's why I don't like riding in cars. I was in my dad's fucking car every single weekend of my high school life.
The McAfee shortcut?
Every fucking, the Tim McAfee shortcut was just something I lived with every fucking weekend, just driving all over the country for soccer.
The one year they documented our traveling team played 180 games that year.
Like, jeez.
It's insane.
Well, because sometimes there's 10 games in a tournament, but still.
You guys are going to the finals, I assume, most tournaments too, so you're playing
His team was incredible. His team was very good. They won a lot.
Plum was a good soccer school.
Yeah, that's why our football team, not great. If all of our soccer players would have played football, I honestly think we could probably win 4 straight state championships.
Wait, Tony played soccer?
Holy man, he was
Tony
good.
Tony kicks, huh?
I did until ninth grade, and then I had to pick Tony between kicks. Football and soccer, and okay. I went football.
He was a good goalie too. Athlete. Kid was an athlete.
Thank you, sir.
Absolute athlete.
Nice.
Now, granted, he runs a route, breaks his foot.
I also now have adult onset asthma as well.
Yeah, that's right. I honestly think I've had asthma my entire life, just nobody would talk about it.
Mine's adult onset.
Oh, of course.
I realized that at an early age. I quit soccer at 8.
That's a lot of running.
Saved myself a lot of trouble.
Well, we used to do these conditioning tests, like 2 miles in 12 minutes or whatever. And honestly, any team I was on was just like, all right, this is a McAfee test to see if we can fucking get it or not. Let's go, Pat. I used to have people like rallying behind me like 11:59, like falling. Jesus Christ. The beep test was a nightmare. The beep test was this thing where it's like 20 yards.
Oh, the pacer test?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
20 yards and cones on one side, and you just have to run to the other side. It's so simple. Just when the beep happens, you have to run to the other side, and then the next beep, you have to run back. And I forget what year it was introduced to my life, but I'll tell you what, that was one of the worst days of my entire fucking life. Beep, and I'm running. And in my head, I'm like, okay, I'm going to try to time this up so I get there perfect timing, and then I'll just continue to jog. So it won't be a sprint stop. It'll just be a continuous jog. You know, this will be just, I can jog for fucking 20 minutes. This is no problem. So then you get there, and then all of a sudden, as you're touching, that thing is actually beeping, and then you got to like pick up the pace. I think we had to get, I don't remember the number. Let's say it was 15 beeps. Like you had to get to 20 beeps or 15 beeps. I got to the number and just fell. And then you got the super hardos that are going for like another 45 fucking minutes. And I'm like, man, why? How do you guys do this? Like, I wish you guys spend more time on like playing soccer than fucking running so much. Like, let's worry about soccer. Maybe we'll be a better team.